That's right, folks. Welcome back. This is Kadima. You know, and we're having a very interesting conversation today. You know, but you know, Kellyanne, let's kind of get on the sensitive side of this whole thing a little bit, right? You know, one of the things is that, you know, that there must be a differentiation between work and home, you know, and work should never interfere with home, you know, it should be two separate entities, you know. So, for instance, and I know a lot of men may have a problem with this for the fact, okay, that your wife probably holds a higher position than you, you know, and the thing is that, I mean, at some point, you know, there should be some sensitive nature as to how we interact with each other when we're in the home.
Right. So you're saying if your wife is the boss of a company, she's allowed to be boss, which is to be leader on her job.
Right.
But when she gets home, you're the king.
No, I'm not saying that. I'm not saying
there's
that.
Nothing, I just give him a props and he just shut the door. That. You see,
no,
please them. I just call him a king after I say he's boss. I choose to give him a king. He shut me down. What do you want,
listen,
Richie?
Listen, let me tell you what I want.
All right, I'm
on the watermelon pink couch. Listen, no, what I'm saying is, all right, fine. Now, at the end of the day, the man is the head of the home, right? That's his territory, that's his throne. He had to deal with what he had to deal with as a man. But the thing is that, you see, being in leadership, you also had to learn to know to follow. And a lot of people don't understand that. Mm-hmm. So the thing is, it's not about, and see, this is what I want to clear here. That's why I say it to you. You know, don't play that cross as you know, all right, fine, he's the king, he's the alpha. Because it's not a matter of that. Remember, both of you all working hand in hand at the end of the day to run the home, to make sure the home run effectively.
Right?
So the thing is, it's not like at the end of the day as a man, you know, you all right, do this and do that and da-da-da-da-da, whatever and thing and ensuring this and that and whatever. It had nothing to do with that.
But I want to know where this man exists. I don't think you're nobody crazy to come and tell your wife, do this.
You'll be surprised,
Trust me. But surprise me.
Nah, you'll be surprised.
Right.
I don't think nobody will mess with you on that. Okay, you're different. you know, but the thing is, at the end of the day, there should be a mutual, you know, how to put it? Understanding between two individuals, right? That
that's you. You see?
Yeah.
Let's see. We established all self full sound vibe. It's man again. Anyway,
yeah,
back
but
to the topic.
It's on vibrate. It didn't ring out. There's a difference. You see?
All right, fine. Justify everything.
Yes.
All right, so ladies, what we basically want to say is, even though we hold, you know, some high positions on our jobs and we're boss, you know, and people look up to us and we give commands and stuff. When you get home to that special someone that you love, take it down a notch. We know you know how to handle your business, but just let him feel, you know.
Well, let him feel.
Let him feel like a man. So, what we're basically saying is, no matter your sex, male, female, two in one, me matter. what we're saying is just let the man be the man. And women, let us just be women, right? Because even though we are boss at what we do, like I could probably cut grass.
Right.
Yeah, the last week I cut the grass. I mean, right now the grass probably won't grow back too fast because it's real mud, you know. But the point is the grass cut, yeah? I would leave that as a man's job. I would let him do his duties.
Right.
So even though we could do it and do it all too well, like I could probably paint. Not probably, I think I could paint. Yeah, painting is just like that. Yeah, so I could paint. I would still leave that up to a man, right? They probably wouldn't do it right, but hey, we love them, not so? Yeah, so we're gonna make them do what they gotta do. And men, just the same way. You guys might say, no, hold on, I'm just saying, I mean, I have to give the ladies props.
Yeah, okay.
Most of the time, when you see something at the house gets done, it's the woman who did it right, the second time. The first time is you guys. No, let's be honest, right? No, let me give y'all an example.
I am so
a house. You just listen. Just listen. You don't have to talk. You just listen.
Mm.
You could just don't talk for the whole next segment. Mm. Just listen. A house to clean.
Mm-hmm.
I would tell you, Richie, straighten up the house for me.
Right?
You would come. You would make sure the chair in line with the carpet. You get that right. You know, you fix something. You think you look. You find everything looking all right. When I come, I can point out at least 10 things that are wrong with this room.
Right, and that's because we wired different.
That's what I'm saying.
Good.
Perfect. So that's all I'm saying.
Mm-hmm.
So not because... We're not saying that you guys can't do it.
Mm-hmm.
It would never be done the way we want it, but because we love you guys, we're willing to settle for it and like fix it after, because this is just bothering me. See, like I know it's supposed to be like this, but then somebody put it like this, and then somebody's a male cameraman, he's supposed to be so. I don't know. It was bothering me for the longest while. Right, so yeah. so now it's straight. Now I can function.
Right.
You understand? Mm-hmm. So that was one thing that would, you know.
Right. But also, you know, bear in mind that, you know, one of the other things that I want to bring across to, and this is for the guys, no, you can stay quiet for your side segment and let me talk, right?
All
right. Calm down. No, what I want to bring to the table is this, right? No, like we were saying earlier, you know, that we had to be sensitive to each other, right?
Definitely.
And men, you know, one of the biggest problems we have in human men these days is this, right?
Mm-hmm.
You know, you might have a problem with the kids.
Mm-hmm.
You know, your wife running up and down with the kids,
yeah.
And she
dealing
with them, and she had to sort them out for school, and they come home from school, and mommy, and then you come
it's
home.
It's always mommy.
Right? It's true. It's always
mommy. It's always
mommy.
I'm mommy struck
too, right? But, but the thing is, you know, you know, as a father, you had to put your foot down and do what you had to do as a father.
Be responsible.
You know,
you
had to discipline your kids.
Yeah.
Discipline your kids. You know what I mean? Because the thing is, at the end of the day, you see, if you don't do it, you understand?
She's left to do it.
Then she's left to do it. And
let's
be
honest. Sometimes we don't do that right.
Yeah.
Because we get tired and we just like watch whatever. I can't be bothered. Men, we need the men to actually step up, pick up the belt, pelt at two slap, at two lap, you know?
Yeah.
And get things in line.
Yeah, because you know, at the end of the day, you know, it's a difference when mommy tell you something
mm-hmm.
and daddy tell you something. Mom tell you, okay, I go and pour the trash, but mom say, yeah, watch the TV, yeah. Your father come and say, go and tear the trash, boy, you know what I mean? You get up, mm-hmm. you go, you take it out, you understand? And say, even though daddy put a licking on you, mm-hmm. you know, you might be vexed at first. But you know, you always find some little small thing if you understand what I'm saying for you and daddy to get back tight. Mom is a total difference. Mom put two lashes on you and then hug you up after you feel you and mom good. You understand what I'm saying?
That's a dread statement because it depends on the mother you have.
Well, that's true too, because some mothers out there, they're different.
But you see, maybe they're single mothers. I think not single mothers. They are forced to be extra tough.
Well, yeah, because
so,
I mean, they're balancing
your point,
for both,
yeah,
right?
Yeah. So your point is valid.
Both,
yeah. In a home where there's mother and father, the mother tends to be the one who has to speak three and four times before she can get the kids to move. And then when the father comes through, she's like, let's say, Troy, just talk to the boy and I talk to the girl, they're not listening. And the father comes, boom, 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 everything get done, like flash just walked in.
I mean, listen, it's just like when you go to school, right? Yeah. And you might get a teacher trouble in school and she say, I want to see your parents. Who's the first person you're running to? Mommy, how going on? My teacher says she want to see you. You won't tell daddy nothing. But then lo and behold, now, while they're in school, sit around and think mommy come and daddy show up. Mm-hmm. You understand?
The whole school see you get a whooping.
Yeah, exactly. You understand? Yeah, so, yeah. I mean, we had to claim the respect in the sense of that sense. We had to take what's ours, what we had to do.
Yes.
You know, and that's a vital factor, especially within the home, you know mm-hmm. what I mean? That we had to step up as men and do what we had to do. If you know we had to discipline the kids, we had to discipline the kids, you know. We had to spread the workload. You can't hire your wife with your kids, you know,
23
hours of the day.
Yeah.
And you want to come
23?
And well,
you may just say 24/7.
Calm down.
24/7. Because that's how it is. Some of these men leave and you go to work early in the morning and them kids didn't see it. So everything is mommy. They come home in the night, they're fast asleep. Mommy. So as far as these kids are concerned, we know there's a man somewhere around because we just see clothes, we see his shoes, we see laundry and the like, but we never see this man.
Mm.
That's how it is.
Right.
I'm just saying.
I'm just saying,
God bless his soul wherever he is.
Yes, I had a serious conversation with this fella.
Let's hope he's not watching.
Let's hope he's not watching Kadima. Yeah,
this is a different side of me.
Yeah.
I am telling you guys. Let me just tell you, to cut a bit. Let me tell you something about myself. I'm a very nice person, very calm, very laid back, very loving, very caring, very tender, very nice. Okay, I'm trying really hard to make myself seem very special here. But don't worry, whoever the guy is, he's gonna survive. He's gonna survive with all his body parts.
Brethren, good luck. Soon, you're from now. Good luck.
All right. What else? Shared responsibilities. We talk about that with the kids. So kudos to all the men who are actually doing what they're supposed to do, and the women who are doing, you know, being single parents and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
You mentioned dishes. What do you think on that?
I think that's shared responsibility.
Richie, does wash the dishes?
Of course,
so
I do. Of course.
Hey, anybody have Richie wife number? Because we could actually.
53. No, I shouldn't get out anyway.
Oh, you're afraid?
Some kind of tricky fellas out there, you know what I mean?
We will find out anyway.
We will find out.
So
but you
share the workload as well?
Definitely.
So you're not one of those who figure just the outside works for men and then the inside.
Let me tell you something. I'll give a classic example of that we're talking about. I was having a conversation with somebody here. I ain't going to take up too much time.
Mm-hmm.
But I was having a conversation. It was a group of us actually having this conversation. And this particular guy in the group, he gets up and he starts to talk and he say, well, you know, here what's going on, my wife had a deal with her real different.
Mm.
And you know, we still sign up because we think, well, you know, is, you know, something real nice and positive and uplifting the dude coming with. And then he's like, let me get an example. For instance, if she washed clothes and she hang it out on the line, you understand? And she had to go in town to make groceries. If rain fall, it stay in there and get wet and not picking it up. You understand what I'm saying? You understand? And I was like freaked out by this because I was like, it's still that people like that are wrong now. Look how Kellyanne watching me. This wasn't me, by the way. I just lying, you know. I'll give you number after, don't worry. Call her and sort of that. Right? But no, but seriously, there actually are still men that exist that way. Wow. You understand? But like, just to go back to what I said, I believe in shared responsibility, you understand?
Definitely,
That we had a,
I mean, know? Listen, we are super women. Yeah. From history. History has proven that. We cut cane. What else we do? Come on, that way. We cut cane, and then we bear children. You understand?
Thank God for that history lesson this morning, eh?
Folks, we'll be back with more Kadima.
Have changed. Gone are the days when there were differentiations between what women should do and what men should do. Now we live in a society where men and women collectively come together now and do what they have to do at the end of the day, either to make ends meet or to basically, you know, function in the home and do what they have to do as couples, as married couples, however. So on the issue of his and hers, hard topic, but collectively together, it could be overcome.
His and hers. Ladies, if you have someone who's willing to share the responsibility, then let him do it. If he wants to mow the lawn, clean the dishes, fluff the pillows, it doesn't matter. If he feels comfortable, I say let him go ahead. But on the other hand, if you want to help out, even better. A man would always be a man and a woman would always be a woman, and there are certain things that we will all feel comfortable doing. But at the end of the day, as long as you love that special someone, you're willing to make their lives a whole lot easier. Thank you for watching Kadima.